Alright, so you can see here that we outnumbered them 2.5 to 1, and we lost only a few men. And we killed, look at that, 3 chevrons for that unit. So very good, very good, very good. And we absolutely obliterated that enemy army. So now it is time to continue the march onto Kai. I'm hoping that that was their last strong force. Looks like North Shinano is unhappy. Interesting. It's okay, because we will recruit a unit next turn. Why is it unhappy, by the way? It's non-clan religion and tax burden. Plus our low repression. Okay. Next turn, we will also research heaven and earth. Should be very nice. And, yeah. So we have a bit of money to spend. On roads, possibility. North Shinano is already constructing a sake den. Could upgrade that temple, but I don't think I need to. Let's get Omi. Iga. No, nothing really. I will get this general down here to Owari. And let's see. Let's get this ninja into some action by heading over here and sabotaging some farms. Let's see. Yeah. So it's much easier to sabotage these buildings out here, the buildings that are... Whoa! That's a rebel. Quick, quick, quick. Take an army. Army. Let's leave back you and you. Will you be unhappy? Very. No, only one. Well, let's recruit 2 units and let's construct. Oh, can't. Let's only recruit 1 unit and let's construct the temple. But we need to march quickly on that rebel town. Always take advantage of the rebel towns in the area if you can. Back to what I was saying. You can see how these farms here and the specialized buildings, they are not inside the town. If I were to go and try and sabotage... let's see if I can show you guys. Oh, no, I can't. But if I were to go and sabotage one of these buildings in here, like a the sword school here, stables or something like that, I'd have a much lower chance of success than if I went to one of these outer buildings, like this school here, the magistrate, or the farm. If I went to there and sabotaged, I'd have a much greater chance of success. So, first one's a success, and he leveled up. So. I don't know what critical success chance is. If anyone could enlighten me on what that is, that'd be very helpful. But I'll take the flash powder bombs. I want sabotaging buildings. Alright. And over here, this guy, he can continue. That's barren soil. Let's see if I can hurt their economy a little bit more. Does this place have any farms? Yes, it does. Meager soil. Any place with better farms? Average soil. And fertile soil. That's the Chosokabe, however. Let's go sabotage their fertile soil farms here. You can see what kind of a soil it is by just scrolling over it. Sabotage successful. You can see what kind of a fertile soil is just by scrolling over the building here. It says improved irrigation, and then in parentheses fertile soil. And fertile soil obviously gives you more money in farming than barren soil like this. And you can also see where a good province is to take next through this method. Let's try and demoralize this army here, or try and convert this Metsuke, because we have more chance. Enemy agent converted. I like to see that, monk. My monk is almost leveled up to 3. But, so we converted this Metsuke there. Next turn, when these guys eventually probably take these Takeda, I will incite a revolt here. and we will just work on our enemies through agent methods. Anyways, diplomatically, no one we can trade with. Although, let's see if I can do something to improve our relations with, let's see, Yashikaga. Let's see if I offer you, they already have military access to our lands. So, what if I offer the Imagawa military access for 5 turns? How much will they pay me? Let's demand a payment of 1,000. Low. Shoot. Well then, that won't work. What about the Yamana? No, the... Uesugi. Let's try and offer them military access for 5 turns. And see how much they'll pay me. And payment, 1,000. Moderate. But let's keep bargaining here. Let's go for 800. Still moderate. Let's go for 700. Oops. I don't want to pay them my money. 700. Still moderate. Oh well. Let's go for only a mere 500. If they won't accept this, I'm gonna keep trying to give them my money. If they won't accept this, then I won't offer them the access. Nope. Oh well, sometimes you can get them to agree, and it often improves the relations. Let's see if we can trick these Urakami into doing this.
Time and honor. Both being wasted. What do you want?
Payments. Demand payment of 1,000. Shoot. Oh well. Well, that was a fail, but I tried. I tried. Next turn, heaven and earth. Blah 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 blah. And things would be looking good. So let's end this turn and go there. Takeda still won a peace treaty. I'm going to decline once again and take Kai first. They still, however, have 4 provinces, one of which is being besieged by the Imagawa, one of which I am about to take, and then 2 to the east of Kai. So they've expanded into Ogigayatsu lands. Oh, and they also have South Shinano. But anyways, unimportant things, Imagawa took Takeda, and that will now allow our monk -1 still. Well, next turn, this will go down. Oops, nope, it'll go up. And we won't get any happiness with the. Well, I hate to do it, but I guess I'm gonna have to exempt these guys from tax until I can send up this unit. There we go. Ta-da. And now we will attack Kai. They don't have any forces here besides that general there. I don't care, however, so I'm just going to take this fortress here. That'll be very beneficial. Kai is well upgraded already. There we go. Decisive victory. And our general leveled up. No, he doesn't. Shoot, I wanted him to level up. Yep, he leveled up. Finally. So this is... Is this our... Yep, we're claimed right now. So we have to be very careful. I think this is our daimyo, which is very good that he's getting these high stars. I want to get the infantry leader. That's pretty much a must. I'm wondering what else to get. +30% of the effectiveness of the rally, +10% of the replenishment rate, +1 morale for all units, -15% upkeep cost. Inspirational sounds pretty good. And he has another retainer. Haiku Poet, plus one to the Daimyo's Honor, very helpful. And Koi Carp, plus 10 to Diplomatic Relations. Jeez, that's a tough one. That's really tough. I'll go for the Koi Carp. Diplomatic relations are very important. Anyways, so we managed to take Kai. Uchi were destroyed. Superior Warhorses were acquired. Province captured Kai. Kai needs to be repaired. It is being repaired. And, next. We are acclaimed right now, so we have to be careful about that. But if I incite a revolt here, incitement failed. Shoot. Well, let's try and take out South Shinano. Why can't I march there? Were these guys sabotaged? Where's Issei? Oh, Issei's still unhappy with us. Yeah, I can see how it would be. Well, let's exempt these guys from tax real quick. Until we can recruit a few more units. And over here, I'm not going to go after Setsu. Setsu is very valuable. It's a nice gateway to the west. Well, you know what? Let's just try once more. There we go. I am going to leave this up to you guys. What should I do with this army here? Shimazuma Sadayu can go down here and attack these rebels. Now, what this would do for us is sabotage. Actually, sabotage with the other ninja first. Because this ninja is closer to being a very high level ninja. Sabotage failed. But let's try and not lose focus. Other sabotage real quick. Sabotage successful. Without losing focus, if I took this province here, Yamato's unhappy as well. Fascinating. Anyways, without losing focus, which I tend to do a lot when I notice weird things in the campaign, if I take Setsu here, I kind of just made the decision for you, but it doesn't have to be made yet because he hasn't gotten there yet. If I take Setsu, I will get one step closer to the realm divide. And is Setsu really a province worth capturing? Other provinces that might be better are South Shinano, because it's inside our lines here. Other provinces might be Mikawa and Totomi. Those might be nice provinces as well, bordering the sea, wealthy provinces. So I might want to focus on those cities that are behind our lines first. However, if I take this, what is a good thing about this is not really their farms, because their farms are average soil. Not really their province wealth, because it's actually quite poor. But this basically choke points right here. This is pretty much the main path of travel for these guys all to come in. So if I took Setsu, this would be an easily defendable place where I could hold off these people to the west and focus on the east. We could try and maintain our allies through the realm divide, although it doesn't look like it because our relations are already poor. Hum-de-dum. Yeah, our relations are pretty poor with everyone. But Yamato are definitely going to be a very key factor here. If I could hold the Yamato as an ally, then I wouldn't need to take Setsu. And I could just use these guys to shield us. until the very end when I take Kyoto. And I think I will take Kyoto last, simply because, I don't know, I might take Kyoto soon, actually. As soon as I hit, I might do it before I hit Legendary. Because what happens there, I'm going a lot longer, but basically what happens there is as soon as you take Kyoto, you go up to Legendary. Oops, not that button. Other button. As soon as you take Kyoto, your Clan Flame goes up to Legendary and you automatically trigger the Realm Divide. So that's a way that I can for sure know where Realm Divide would be and when Realm Divide would be, and I would have it on my terms. So I could already take Kyoto before that happens. And then Kyoto is a very defensible place, and it would be my most western city, which means that they would all attack Kyoto, and that would be very easily defensible with its massive garrison units, number of garrison units. Although I'm not sure if it would be that massive for me, because I'm eco. Anyways, the plus side to taking Setsu here is that it's a rebel, and if I do that now, I won't engage in war with any of these factions here. So that's a good plus side for taking Setsu. Normally, you want to take rebel provinces first and foremost because it doesn't endanger you joining any wars that you don't want to join. But let's end this part here. I'll let you guys tell me what you guys think. Please let me know, and please point me in the right direction if you guys have any tips. I would much appreciate it because we are at a critical turning point in this campaign. We have 13 out of 25 provinces held. Usually in another 3 or 4 provinces, Realm Divide will be triggered. So right now we are pretty much in the build-up stage for Realm Divide. One province here will be South Shinano. That's a sure fact. Another province might be Musashi here. That's another relatively sure fact, because I'd want to take out the Takeda. So that's 2 provinces already, so we'd be up to 15. Usually Realm Divide triggers at 17 or something like that for a short campaign. So maybe the other 2 would be Makawa and Totomi, just to secure off this this border here, this coast-to-coast, pretty much. And once that happens, Realm Divide would be hit, and I really need to know what you guys think I should be doing, because this is partly your campaign as well. So I'm going to leave it on that note. We are researching Attack by Fire. It's a relatively good choice. Although I might want to focus on scholarship for the monk cav and eventual units that could be trained through that. But I'm going to leave it there. Things are looking very good in the Empire. Our clan income has gone down slightly, but we have conquered a vast swath of Japan, and we are pretty much in the unstoppable path to Realm Divide. So, thank you guys for watching, and I hope you guys enjoyed.